the service.
Oh.
Yes. She's a person.
Yes.
She's quite a gal.
I remember hearing some wonderful stories there, Lynn, of your country and during the Nazi occupation.
Yes.
The only time that the 4th of July celebration was ever told was ever interrupted. But that every morning, the 4th of July night, it was at sunrise. The Danish flag and the American flag. No one to this day knows the people who erected it.
Step over.
Yeah, I want to go with it. Excuse me.
When they start to ask questions, they can identify. You can identify yourself with the names of the papers when you
start to ask. Okay, so I come because Vic's been taking care of everything very well. Over there.
We agree with that.
That's a good one.
Schedule at home about 9 o'clock. She's just fine.
I was going to say, you're more pop than we are, generally speaking.
Well, welcome all of you. And
thank you.
I'm at your mercy.
That's fine, brother.
That's the little word you're waiting for.
First, let me thank you on behalf of the Hearst newspaper editors and Washington Bureau who are here. We're very appreciative of your receiving us, and we respect what we know is a very tight schedule. And I'll get the ball rolling, if I may, Mr. President, by asking the first question, which is that you're approaching the near point of your first term, and I'm sure our editors would like to know what achievements in your administration you're happiest with and about which items you're most disappointed.
Well, I suppose basically, I am disappointed in it. Out of the economic program that we proposed in 1981, we in the legislative process had to be willing to give up certainly a sizable portion of the tax cuts that we believe would be stimulated to the economy. We never did get all that we wanted in the line of budget cuts. And so far now have not yet, but I feel still must approach the structural part of government spending.
I had the opportunity of making some very good friends and strengthening the relationships between our two countries.
Well, that is an issue, but we look forward to working with you and working with President Bernardo. Very much willing to cooperate in any way we can, as I still feel as I did 2 years ago, but, and for a long time before that. The two countries should be closer neighbors than we have been in 2 years.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. President de la Madrid has asked me to convey to you a message in answer to the very kind words and congratulations on the other side of the translation.
Every time it gets into the media with their expression. My proposal for that and our support of that is based on one thing and one thing only. Yes, we spoke of the fact that there would be jobs because of the spirit of the times and what has happened. But over a year ago, Drew Lewis presented to us a frightening report and a true report of the potential for tragedy that we face with particularly the group situation with our highways. And I asked him a year ago if he could forego that and hold off for a year. And he came back a year later with this. The conditions are worse. There is an economic factor also that doesn't have to do with government spending, it has to do with the cost of the people out there. And that is, we know, and I don't know that he's made a survey of all business in the industry, but we know particular corporations in which their added costs are in the millions of dollars from simply having to reroute the trucks carrying their material to a highway system that will avoid the bad spots in the highway. And this, as I say, amounts to millions of dollars a year of added cost, which is then paid by the consumer, contributes to inflation, and so forth. So our purpose in sending that bill up was exactly what we called it, a 5-cent user fee, gas tax to be used for that purpose of restoring, putting back the things. I just have to put that in. But now, we're moving to defense spending. The Senate needs to complete action on the appropriations bill. And I recognize that we need to reach agreement to funding of the MX procurement with an understanding of the basic mode decision for the Congress can be delayed and will come sometime later. And I think that possibly an agreement has been reached out between some and John. Could you just briefly summarize what it is that we're talking about?